I can say
good morning, everybody. It's starting again. It's 1:33 in the morning and I cannot sleep. So I'm gonna make myself a cup of hot chocolate and see if that'll help me to sleep.
My last packet of hot chocolate. I'm going to have to buy more. And since I got up, look who's decided to get up too. Mr. Boomer and Miss Bootsy over here. And Miss Bootsy's thinking that it's time to get fed. No, it's not. It's only 1 o'clock in the morning. You don't get fed now. Sorry. I love you. Stop petting me, just feed me.
I'm not feeding either of you.
So here's my cup of hot chocolate. It's got some French vanilla creamer in it. I'm gonna try and sit down somewhere and just relax and drink that. And hopefully I can go back to bed and go to sleep.
Hello, everybody. So here we are back at Kaiser once again. Cody brought me.
Say hi, Cody.
So, guys, here we are again back at Kaiser. I have another doctor's appointment today. Cody took me. And it's with my urologist to find out what all that thing was last week about the bladder infection that supposedly wasn't a bladder infection. So we'll figure everything out. Then we got some errands to run, so we'll catch you all a little later. So, hey guys, just finished with my doctor's appointment and not very happy. I have this new thing called, I can't say it, so that's what it's called. And first thing we try is another medication and diet. And one of the side effects of the medication is loss of hair. I'm not happy about that because I lose a lot of hair to begin with. So that's our first step. If I still have issues, the second step is a slight operation. It's an in and out type thing, no cutting or anything, but I still don't want to have to go through something like that. But that's our second option. And then our third option is where I have to come into the office, to the medical office, once a week to have a catheter and some medication put into my bladder through the catheter. I don't really want to do that either. So I don't want to do any of this, but I have to do what I have to do. So anyway, enough about that. We're off to have some, run some errands and have some fun. So here we are once again, my normal routine, doctor's appointment, running errands, and Betty Faye's. So here we are at Betty Faye's. I got a mushroom cheeseburger with onion rings, and Cody over here. Shaking his head no. He got chicken strips,
onion rings,
mashed potatoes with gravy, and some bread over there that looks mighty tasty. Cody doesn't like being on camera.
I really don't. But I'm doing this for Val. Because I love you.
We love you too. I ate every last bite, considering this might be the last good thing I get to eat. Yes, I am upset.
Hello, guys. I didn't film going to the grocery store. After my appointment, we went to the post office because I had to mail a package, and then we went to Betty Faye's and had some food, and then we went to the grocery store. So I picked up some stuff to make for dinner tonight, and no, Christopher, we're not having dead bird again tonight. We're going to have some steak. So I know I said I wasn't going to make this into a cooking channel, and I still don't plan on doing that, but I want to kind of put this together and show you guys and let you guys know how it tastes. Everybody seems to be interested in the recipes I'm using. And they're all healthy and low sodium and all that kind of stuff. So I will do that. I went and I bought some really nice big pieces of juicy ribeyes. And bell pepper. Of course, mushrooms. And my red onion that I get to use in my ninja again. I love my ninja. And I'm going to kind of put them together in the packets like I did with the chicken the other night. So we'll have to see how that turns out. So I will get back with you.
Mushroom.
Yes, that is a mushroom.
Mushroom.
So, I got the steaks all put together in here. And what I did is I just put a little bit of olive oil and Monterey steak seasoning on there. Mushroom. And Megan loves a lot of vegetables.
Mushrooms.
Do you like me cooking?
Yes. You need to cook every day.
Has it been tasting good? You got something on your eyelash.
Yeah.
No, you've been touching gross steak. I washed my hands.
Trying to stick your fingers in my eye after touching steak.
I washed my hands after I did that.
I was going to say something. Oh, you need to cook every day. And you need to clean my room. Clean my room.
I can't.
Clean my room.
I think you should clean my room.
I think you should clean my room.
I think you should clean the whole house.
I think you should clean my room.
I think you should make dinner, too.
I think you should clean my room.
So, anyway...
String cheese!
I got a knife.
I don't care.
And people say I wave knives around when I'm cooking, and they make them nervous. She just threw that string cheese at me. Throw my knife at her. Anyway, I'm gonna cut up the mushrooms and put them in here again and wash them off really
Starbucks
well.
Cup.
Yeah, she's still addicted to Starbucks.
No, it's not. I'm gonna put water in it.
And she's got a squeaky voice.
Shut that up.
So I'll get back with you guys later.
Mushroom!
I think this one's bigger.
Mushrooms! Look how big these are!
Look how big these are!
Big mushrooms. Mushrooms. Mushroom. Mushroom. Oh, this camera's really good. Do you see how good this camera is? It looks like a microscope. Mushroom.
Megan's not obsessed with mushrooms.
See, I put water in it. There's water in my cup.
Okay, so I cut up my bell peppers. Sorry. So I cut up my bell peppers, my green, yellow, and red. And I'm going to mix those all up with the mushrooms, just so it's a little mixed together. I really wish my island had an outlet to it, so I could use my ninja over there instead of coming back and forth, but here we go. That's about all I want to do, because I don't want it to be finely chopped. So here they are, all ready to be wrapped up. And I guess I have a little bit of extra stuff here, so I'll probably just fry that up separately. So there we are, all three packets ready to go. All I have to do later is pop them in the oven. Hey guys, Kevin's home, so let's see what dinner looks like.
Looks like aluminum foil.
all there is. Just big balls of aluminum foil.
My favorite.
That's what we eat around here. What do you think?
Looks good.
Okay.
Looks yummy.
All right, there's three of them. One for me, one for you, and one for Megan.
I only get one?
There's a big steak in there. It's ribeye steaks, and then there's mushrooms, onions, and bell peppers.
Yumsters.
And I used your Montreal steak rub stuff.
Coolness.
So, ready?
Yep.
Okay.
So, no dead bird tonight.
Nope, dead cow.
How is it?
It's good.
Very good? Flavorful?
Mm-hmm.
Is it tough? No?
Nope.
Good. And are you eating veggies?
Yeah.
You're eating veggie? Oh my gosh. I'm so glad I have that on film, guys. Kevin put a red bell pepper in his mouth. It looks just so yummy.
The last time you did vegetables, it was cauliflower and broccoli and carrots, all of which are gross.
And zucchini.
Yeah. Need
and
I say
squash.
More? This is good stuff.
Okay, glad you liked it.
I guess I'll keep you. No dessert this week. You've been cut off at the bar.
Meow.
No more for you.
Meow.
No more for you.
Meow.
Boy, you're a fickle cat.
Hi, everybody. It's the Valerie and Boomer Show.
Yeah, I don't understand it either.
I think you just called them freckles, didn't you?
Of course not.
Guess what time it is? It's howdy doody time. It's howdy doody time. You'll do the hokey pokey, right? Put your right paw in, you put your right paw out. Your right paw in and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around, but you're falling off my lap. That's what it's all about.
He's falling again.
I know, my lap, my belly's too big. Did we hear a door for a reason?
You have a cat on you.
Hello.
What do you have in your cup?
It's gross water mixed with coffee because my coffee got watered down and then I was thirsty, so I filled it with water.
What is this piece of paper we are looking at?
It's just a progress report form that I have to get filled out.
By who?
My teachers.
You want me to fill out?
If you'll give me A's.
Mr. Spasmodic, are you Russian? Do you have big plane? Is big plane because it's Russian? Russian plane? Big plane? It's Russian. I'm going to go eat food and change and get comfortable and watch American Dad. Because I'm Russian and Russians like American Dad. I don't know if that's true.
Bye.
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 Shut up.
So everybody, back to shoutouts!
Shut up.
We have some new members to the community! Shelter from Wind, welcome to the neighborhood! Real Madrid, originally from Queens, New York, now lives in Northern California, welcome to the neighborhood!
Vincent Gutierrez, welcome to the neighborhood. We hope you all enjoy the videos and that we can put a smile on your face or make you laugh a little bit. And Angie Lupus Life, thanks for the big thumbs up on the bar. We really, really like the bar.
So does Boomer.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Everybody notice the sign back here? Can you see? The number 9?
Number 9?
9 days. And apparently...
Apparently?
A lot of people really liked the turkey taco recipe.
Good.
Yeah, a lot of people really like the turkey taco recipe. A lot of people said they're going to try it.
Good.
So, I hope everybody tries it, and it turns out great, and you all love it. And just remember where you got the recipe from. And I cooked for 4 days in a row straight. And what was your favorite meal?
Probably tacos.
The turkey tacos? And then the second was the chicken with veggies.
Mm-hmm.
And tonight we had steak with veggies, but the veggies weren't cooked enough. I don't think. So, but anyway, it's time for Neighborhood Community Scroll!
I actually call the credit roll.
Oh, okay. Time for Neighborhood Community Credit Roll!
Well, get on with it. It's gone on forever.
You are all part of our neighborhood community, each and every one of you. We would not be here if it weren't for you all. We love you. Thank you. Thumbs up, and we will see you tomorrow. Bye. Oh, that? What?